Hey guys, so today we're going to be taking a look at a few gift ideas for $25 and below. So with Father's Day right around the corner and the fact that it can be so tricky to come up with cool gift ideas, especially if you're on a little bit of a tighter budget, I just want to go ahead and put together a list of some of my favorite travel and EDC items that I've enjoyed using that come in at around that lower price point. And I've always been a big fan of this type of video. I've watched so many of them from channels like Jonathan Morrison and Your Average Consumer. So it's always been enjoyable and helpful for me to see these types of lists to just kind of discover new items. And so I'm just gonna be doing a quick overview of these items, nothing too in-depth. If there's anything you'd like to see me do a closer look on in the future, please let me know in the comments. But for now, let's just go ahead and jump in and take a closer look at a few of my favorite travel and EDC items that come in at $25 or less. And so the first item on my list is the Gerber Shard Multi-Tool. And I feature this in pretty much every travel video that I do. It's always so hard to find a multi-tool that's relatively TSA compliant. I've traveled this to a variety of countries and never had any issues. And so it's a really small and compact tool that has a pry bar, a bottle opener, a flathead screwdriver, and a Phillips head screwdriver. And it comes in at around $7 to $9. I've seen the price fluctuate a little bit, but it's just a really simple and durable accessory that anybody can attach to their keychain. And it's just gonna be really useful to have throughout your day to day. And so next up, I just have a few multi-port cables from Chiffon, and these typically come in at around $7 to $8 and just really useful to toss into any bag that you typically have with you. They have a variety of different configurations and lengths, and I love that these have some lightning USB-C ports and even some micro USB. So just all the different ports that you'll need for the different tech accessories that are common nowadays. Next up is an item that you've probably heard me mention in a few of the different EDC videos that I've done, and that is the Fisher Space Pen. This still continues to be one of the accessories that I travel with no matter where I go. I love how small and pocketable this pen is, and the fact that when you open it up and place the case on the top, it turns into pretty much a full-size pen, and it writes very easily and consistently. So it's just a very reliable and easy accessory to carry around with me in a pocket or in one of my bags. And it comes in at $15 to $20, so it's gonna be an affordable and maybe surprising little gift for anybody that needs a pen for their day-to-day. Next up is the Rocketbook Everlast Mini. And if you've watched any of my videos in the past, you know that I typically like to have a notebook on hand to just jot down quick notes. And typically I carry something like a Field Notes or Moleskine. And when I found out about the Rocketbooks, I was really excited at the fact that they offer the writing experience, but they have the ability to erase and reuse. And that to me seems like a little bit more environmentally friendly option. And it's just nice to think that, hey, maybe I don't have to buy notebooks again in the future. And so I have a Field Notes here for comparison, and you can see that they're very close in size. And the mini version of the Rocketbook includes a pen, which is specifically made to work with the Rocketbook. It's very easy to purchase these on Amazon, and it also includes a little microfiber cloth that you can use to wipe down your writings whenever you want to get more space back in the notebook. The experience of writing on this is very much like writing on a normal notebook. I was worried that it would smudge or that it would be uncomfortable to write with, but it just feels very good. And as far as erasing, that's also very simple. You just wet the microfiber cloth a little bit and the ink comes out very easily. It doesn't leave any sort of stains. I did notice that some of the notes that I've left for a longer period of time, I had to push down a little bit harder to erase, but for the most part, it's worked very well. And then a nice little feature with the Rocketbook is that it has these little QR codes on the bottom, and that combines with an app for your smartphone that allows you to scan these and automatically send them to a variety of the different cloud services that you might use, like Google Drive, Trello, your email, Dropbox. So they have a lot of different connections. And for the most part, the scanning is pretty cool. I don't know if it works much better than one of the normal scanning apps that I've used on my phone, like Scannable or even something like the iOS Notes app. So even though it's not a feature that I might use too much, it's still nice to have that peace of mind to be able to just scan and save everything before erasing completely. The next item on the list is this bendy tripod that I found from a company called UB Size. And so I've always been curious to try out GorillaPods, as we've seen with popular vloggers like Casey Neistat and Peter McKinnon. They always have the big GorillaPod to hold their large SLR cameras. But they're pretty expensive, and honestly, my camera's not that heavy, and I typically don't do any sort of self-shooting or standing on tripods with my mirrorless camera. I just use either my iPhone 10 or my GoPro Hero 7 Black. And for the most part for that, this tripod works very well. It's much sturdier than other tripods that I found in this price range in the past. It also offers a nice amount of stability and flexibility. I also like the size. It's not really small. This one wraps around some thicker branches and it gives you a nice amount of height. And if you do want to do some vlogging, you can hold it out a pretty nice amount. So just a very flexible and nice tripod. I also love that it includes the phone mount, which is typically sold as a separate accessory with some of the higher end brands. And this is a really sturdy mount. I've been very happy with how tightly it holds my phone. And you can also easily clip on your GoPro. It includes some of the adapters and it even includes a Bluetooth Bluetooth remote for if you want to take selfies or anything like that. So just a very versatile and useful tripod. Whenever you see any of my B-roll in my videos, this is what I'm using to shoot outside. So I've really enjoyed using this. I haven't had any issues with the legs falling over or my phone or GoPro falling off when I hang this in a tree or something like that. So if you're on a tighter budget or you know somebody who's really into video and photography and just needs a very useful little tripod, this is going to be a good option to check out. Next up is an item you've probably seen in a lot of my videos in the past. This is the BagSmart cable organizer. This continues to be one of my favorite ways to organize all of my tech dongles and cables and smaller accessories. I love the slim form factor. The build quality has been really good, especially for the price point. It has a nice look and just tons of organizational options and bands on the inside to keep everything in its place. So if you know somebody with a lot of stuff that they take throughout the day, either a student or somebody who goes into the office, this is gonna be a nice stylish option to check out. And then the last item on the list is a set of packing cubes from a company called Bag Ale. And so these packing cubes are compressible and very lightweight. They're gonna be a great accessory for any travelers that you know that really love to organize all of their clothing and keep everything easy to find inside their bags. On the channel, we're big fans of modular packing and organization, so I was very excited to start testing these out, and I've been really impressed with just how lightweight and thin they are, in addition to the fact that they can compress your clothes down. So they offer these in a variety of sizes. They come in at a really reasonable price. And the company also offers standard type packing cubes if you travel with a larger bag. But for me, because I like to travel with smaller travel backpacks, this is gonna be a really great option and just help save that little bit of extra space and weight while I'm walking around with a bag. And so that's it. That's my list of gift ideas that come in at $25 or below. I hope you guys liked it. I would really love to do more of these videos in the future at different price point for some of the different things that I've been checking out. So if that would be interesting to you, please let me know in the comments and definitely subscribe so you don't miss those when they come out. And if you guys have any cool budget, travel, and EDC gift ideas that I missed, please let me know. I'm always looking for cool things to have on hand for different occasions. And if you guys found this video useful, please go ahead and give us a like. And as always, thank you so much for watching.